All right, let's get an update now on our Today weather alert for Australia's east coast. Record rain and flood danger forecast across three states this morning. We're joined now by Assistant Commander Sean Kearns of the SES. Sean, good morning to you. Let's talk about this record in Sydney. It is all but set to tumble, right?
Yeah, thank you. Good morning, Sylvia. Yeah, look, the predictions are that that is going to fall over the coming days. We have seen significant rain falling this year, which has caused a number of significant flooding events to communities, not only across Sydney, but across New South Wales. Over the last couple of days, we've seen significant rain falling in western New South Wales, and we've across already saturated catchments, which has seen river rises and renewed flooding that has already been going on for a couple of months out there. And we've got a greater risk now of further flooding occurring across communities across western New South Wales.
So based on those latest forecasts, which areas are you really worried about in terms of flooding?
Yeah, the areas we're really focusing on are communities of Forbes, Warren, Wee Waa, Dubbo, Ningen, Bathurst, and they're the ones that we've got to focus on, but there's still numerous other communities out there as well. So SES has over 40 advice or watch and act warnings out across the state. So we'll ask people to go to the New South Wales SES website to get the latest warnings for their area, and that will also be able to provide them with the actions that they need to take to keep themselves, okay, their family and their friends safe.
Good.
We are also watching this weather system as it may move across metropolitan areas on the east coast. So we do have a minor flood warning out for areas in the Hunter and parts of the Hawkesbury, Nepean and Colo. Although at this stage, we aren't expecting to see any significant flooding like we have in the past for that Hawkesbury, Nepean area.
Okay, well, that will be some relief for people in those areas. But this isn't the end of it, is it? The next 24 hours, there's more to come across the weekend. What can we expect?
Absolutely. There will be potentially significant more rain falling across western New South Wales in particular. And again, that may come across along the coast. At this stage, we're just waiting to get updated information from the Bureau about where that may hit. But that could be parts of metropolitan Sydney and the Hunter. And again, what we do ask people at this stage is to listen to the warnings. Just start being prepared for what they need to do. Understand what the flood risk is where you are. Have your important personal belongings ready to go if needed. And follow the advice of New South Wales SES if you are asked to take action.
It's just relentless, isn't it? Assistant Commander Sean Kearns, we appreciate your time. Thank you.
Australia's east coast is right now being smashed by heavy rainfall again. Sydney soaked overnight, just under 50 millimetres falling in areas of Sydney's west over the past 24 hours alone. Another 100 mils forecast to hit the harbour city this weekend, which is set to top the annual rainfall record of more than 2.2 metres, which was set way back in 1950. Gabby Boyle is tracking the forecast for us this morning. Gabby, emergency services on alert.
They certainly are, Carl. An incredible record set to be broken over the weekend. The wettest year on record for Sydney. And that will come when we top that 2,194 millimetres that were expected to reach over the weekend. The worst hit area overnight with that terrible rain that we've seen has been Holsworthy with 49 millimetres. But right across Sydney today, we're expected to once again get an absolute drenching. And that comes with warnings not only here in Sydney, but right across New South Wales for floods in river areas, including the Upper Hunter, the Lower Hunter, the Darling River, the Macquarie River and the Lachlan River. I can tell you here at Bondi this morning, conditions are pretty miserable. Very strong winds, the surf's looking pretty ordinary, and that rain is coming and going throughout the morning as well. The New South Wales Premier, he has responded to the situation we found ourselves in recent months with those continued floods in low-lying areas, promising to raise the level of Warragamba Dam by up to 14 metres. Certainly, it has been a very turbulent year for communities in those low-lying areas, flood after flood, Carl.
Sure has, Gabby. Thank you.
OK, let's get the latest forecast from Senior Meteorologist at the Weather Bureau, Jonathan Howe. Jonathan, good morning to you. Will that record fall?
Good morning, Alex. Well, it's a number we're keeping very close on here at the Bureau, and it is likely to fall this weekend. So at the moment, Sydney's just 25 to 27 millimetres off that all-time record, which is set back in 1950. And that is extremely significant because records go all the way back to the 1850s at the CBD site. We saw more than 25 millimetres overnight, but with that second round of rainfall coming to Sydney and the East Coast from tomorrow, that record is likely to fall.
OK, not good. Let's talk about floods, and we're expecting a few of them, both Victoria and New South Wales under warnings. Which areas under those flood warnings, Jonathan?
That's exactly right. So with all that rainfall across the east coast, not just New South Wales and Victoria, but Queensland and northern Tasmania as well, are under both flood watches and flood warnings. But the main areas of concern are very much across New South Wales. So first, across inland parts of New South Wales, almost every river on and west of the Great Divide could see moderate to major flooding. And that includes places like Tamworth, Dubbo and Bathurst. So really reminding residents out there to keep an eye on those warnings. Follow all the advice from the SES. But if you're on the coast, including Sydney, you are now under a flood watch as well. We are potentially looking at minor to moderate flooding, and that does include the Hawkesbury and Nepean rivers, and also flood watch for Wollongong. So just reminding people right across the east coast to keep an eye on those warnings and, of course, stay out of those floodwaters.
And, Jonathan, really quickly, when will we see the sun again? When's this rain over?
Well, for this particular burst, we'll see some dry skies Monday, Tuesday, but then there's more rain coming next week. And unfortunately, this is the pattern we'll see until the end of the year, potentially into early 2023.
So Monday, Tuesday, sun, then rain again. All right, Jonathan Howe, thanks so much for being with us.
Well, there's no doubt that we're seeing more rain come right across our state today off the back of some widespread falls yesterday. I'm coming to you from the city at the moment, and the wind is frightful, and the rain is almost coming in horizontal. So we're in for another tough day right across the city, but in fact right across the state. We've got communities now that have been in flood out west for 12 months or more, and we've got, you know, more rain expected.
Where is the flooding threat over the next couple of days?
Oh, look, there's flooding threats right across New South Wales. As we know, our landscapes are entirely saturated. Our dams are basically full, and the river systems, those channels, are also full. And on that basis, any additional rain, even the smallest amount, vastly increases the risk of both riverine, but particularly flash flooding, given the nature of the weather system that's coming through. So whether it's the central west, Forbes just on 12 months ago now saw those extraordinary floods come through their town. The Lachlan River system is absolutely full to bursting. So we're keeping a close eye on that. Down south, through those southern communities along the Murrumbidgee, of course, and then right here in Sydney, we've got particularly the Upper Nepean. We're keeping a close eye on that as well. So all across New South Wales at the moment, there's risks everywhere, and just asking people to work with us through this time.
Can I ask you, Steph, too, just about the dam wall project for New South Wales for the benefit of those living in Sydney? You're going to raise the wall. When is that going to happen? Is it definitely going to happen?
Oh, look, we've made a commitment as a state that raising that wall of Warragamba by 14 metres is a critical infrastructure project for us. And the Premier, was very strong on that yesterday, supported by the Planning Minister, the Water Minister. We will now move through these processes in haste and get on to doing that project. It's critical for flood mitigation right through that area.
Residents in that part of, Sydney's west have been asking for this for a very long time. They've been getting hammered now for months, for years. How long is it going to take, do you think, for that wall to be built?
Well, there's still processes that have got to be adhered to. It's a big and complex project, as I've said before.
And it's
Building large infrastructure does tend to take some time, but it is a project that we are committed to. The Premier has made that clear. He's working with the federal government. We will continue to press up on this project. We know how important it is to the communities of Western Sydney.
All right. Well done. Thanks for being with us today. Stay safe out there. You look like our weather
Thank
person
you.
This morning.